What's really behind the gender gap in COVID-19 deaths? Ever since the early stages of the coronavirus pandemic, there has been a noticeable difference between the number of male and female deaths attributed to this disease. While many doctors and scientists around the world were quick to conclude that the cause was inherently related to the differences in both genders' biology, and despite the fact that they have produced significant evidence to support these claims, recent statistical evidence, as well as the comparison with other similar pandemics that have hit us in the past, have raised the question of whether this gender gap really exists at all. In today's video, we'll answer that burning question in the heads of all genetic males around the world. Am I more likely to die if I catch COVID-19 for having XY chromosomes instead of XX? We'll analyze the evidence from both sides, and by the end, you'll either be more worried than before, or you'll have a bit more peace of mind. But first, please support our channel and give us a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any new updates on COVID-19 science made easy. A small disclaimer before we begin, to avoid any confusion and to not discriminate people of different genders, we will refer to males and females in genetic terms. In other words, females in this context are those with XX chromosomes, while males are those with XY. Regardless of the gender identities being masculine, feminine, genderqueer, agender, cisgender, or transgender. The difference in the number of COVID-19 deaths between males and females. Before we dive into an analysis of cause and effect, let's take a look at the numbers that spawned this debate. Ever since the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic, there was already an observable difference between the proportion of male and female deaths. It's not just that there is a higher number of deaths among men, but the proportion of infected men that ultimately died was already seemingly higher than that of women. But the real difference was noticed when Italy was hit. During the first months of 2020, Italy held the unwanted record of being the country with the highest death toll. And when looking at the statistics coming from Italy, everyone noticed that men were twice as likely to die from COVID-19 than women. This, coupled to the fact that men were also likelier to contract the virus in the first place, raised an alarm that traveled the world. Other countries started looking more carefully at their own statistics and realized that this pattern was repeating everywhere, although not with the same numbers. Based on today's statistics, some countries have vastly higher total number of male deaths than female deaths, such as in Afghanistan, where 4 times more men have died than women. Similar statistics can be seen in Bangladesh, Burkina Faso, Kenya, Malaysia, Maldives, and Croatia. In the vast majority of other countries where sex disaggregated data is available, more men have died than women. However, even those cases like Canada, where the number of female deaths was only slightly higher than male deaths, the actual risk of dying due to infection is still higher in men. The only reason countries like Canada and Estonia have seen more female deaths is because in those countries, there have also been more confirmed female cases than male. But when you compare the proportion of deaths among the confirmed cases, the XY males once again take the lead. Whichever the case may be, there is an obvious difference in the way that coronavirus affects men and women. Is this simply the consequence of differences in social behavior, occupation, and pre-existing conditions? Or is there something inherently different in our cells that make women stronger than men when it comes to fighting disease? Keep watching to find out. What are the possible biological causes of this difference? There are an immense number of differences between men and women at the biological level, but there are 2 basic differences that most experts agree are the key to why women are better at surviving diseases than men. Number 1, genetics. As we all learned at school, women have 2 X chromosomes, one from the mother and one from the father, while men only have 1 X chromosome from the mother and 1 Y chromosome from the father. The X chromosome contains thousands of genes, many of which are known to be involved in the response of our immune system to pathogens like viruses. The fact that women have 2 different X chromosomes gives them a 2-fold advantage over men. On the other hand, they have 2x the number of available responses to protect their bodies against different viruses. Where one X chromosome could be great at identifying the coronavirus, the other could be great at destroying infected cells, giving an overall more efficient and effective immune response. On the other hand, the fact that men only have one X chromosome means that if it contains damaged genes, there's no second backup to take its place, because it's all they have. If the damaged gene is involved in the immune system, then they'll be less fit to fight off the coronavirus. Number 2. Sex hormones. Another factor that has a heavy impact on our immune system, and on our entire body for that matter, are hormones. Immunologists believe that testosterone has an inhibiting effect on our immune system, while estrogen can potentiate it. Furthermore, progesterone, another hormone women have plenty of, has anti-inflammatory effects that also protect a woman's body against the harmful side effects of a hyperactive immune system, which is responsible for many of COVID's most deadly secondary side effects, which could explain why there's such a striking difference between the number of men and women in intensive care units due to COVID. Doctors are already doing clinical trials treating male patients with either estrogen, progesterone, or a combination of both. Results are still not in yet, but they're hopeful that it could really make a difference and save thousands of lives. Even though these hypotheses are likely true, many other researchers have been putting the loop on the statistical data to see if there really is such a gender gap at all, and if it simply isn't the consequence of a series of confounding factors. Keep watching to learn what this could mean for you. What's really behind this gender gap? There's another school of thought that disagrees with the assertion that the gender gap in COVID deaths is due to inherent differences in our biology. While it is tempting to look only at general averages in the statistical data, doing this implies losing much valuable information. This is why more researchers every day are looking at the data more closely and analyzing it in one country or even one state at a time. The first evidence that things aren't what they seem is the fact that the proportion in which the male death rate is higher than the female's varies broadly across different countries. In some places, the male fatality rate is twice that of females, while in other, both have an identical fatality rate. This points to socioeconomic and cultural differences rather than to biological differences. Researchers found three key differences that could really explain the gender gap in COVID deaths. Keep watching, as these differences could help you get a better idea of how likely to die you really are if you were to catch coronavirus. Number 1. Social and occupational differences. It has happened before that differences in male and female occupation affect the probability of catching certain diseases. Men are several times more likely to catch the MERS virus in Saudi Arabia only because it is transmitted by camels, and only men work with these ruminants. A similar occupational difference in gender has been observed in some countries. Regarding the present COVID pandemic, results suggest that the only reason why, in some countries, the fatality rate of women is so low is due to a much higher infection rate among health workers, which are predominantly female. They also tend to be young and in very good health, so they're much more likely to pull through and survive the disease. Number 2. Gender behavior. Even in countries where there is a comparable number of female and male infections, the higher number of male deaths can be explained by differences in behavioral patterns. For example, men are more likely to smoke than women, which is a serious risk factor for COVID. They're also less inclined to personal hygiene and have worse eating habits, all of which is detrimental in their ability to fight off the disease, making them more prone to dying when they are infected with coronavirus. Number 3. Pre-existing conditions. Finally, when we account for pre-existing conditions, or comorbidities as they are called, everything starts to come together. If you compare the fatality rates between men and women that share the same risk factors such as asthma, heart disease, and cancer, they turn out to be almost identical. The fact that men are more likely to suffer from these conditions is able to explain most of the differences between the male and female fatality rates. All in all, even though there do seem to be cases where the difference in fatalities cannot be totally accounted for by these three factors, biological differences between men and women cannot alone be considered as the only cause of this gender gap. more data is still necessary, which is why it's so alarming that the United States, the current world record holder for COVID deaths, is not doing everything it can to disaggregate or separate its statistical data according to gender. It's something to think about when assessing the country's response to this health crisis. Does this evidence worry you more than before, or does it give you peace of mind while you confront the situation? Tell us how you feel in the comments section below. If you've enjoyed this video, please support us with a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more updates on the war against the invisible enemy. If you haven't seen this video popping up on your screen, go check it out, and you'll be glad you did.